Good evening to all of you. Today we are going to study functions in C programming language. So what do you mean by functions in C? Function is a subprogram used to perform certain task. Basically, we write functions when there is a repeated code available in the program. Suppose there is an addition task I need to perform 1000 times in my program, suppose. So if you don't know functions, so I need to write the same task 1000 times and assume that to perform the addition task, if the line of code required is suppose 3, so I need to write around 3000 lines of code to perform that job, correct? So C language has given us the alternative, that is called function. We have to write the function only once, and we can call the function n number of times in wherever it is required. So it means function is nothing but write once, use many times. We have already used so many functions, inbuilt functions, in our previous programs, in previous chapters. So there are two types of functions available in C programming language. One is called library function, also called as built-in functions in C. And second category of functions is called as user-defined functions. Now we'll see the first category of functions that are called as library functions or built-in functions. These are the predefined functions. Library functions are the predefined functions whose meaning is known to the compiler in advance. It means that the code of that function is written by someone else for us. We just have to pass the parameter to the function and get the result of that function. The information of all the library functions is stored in some header files. For example, we always use one header file called as stdio.h, hash include stdio.h, which consists of the information of all the input and output functions such as printf and scanf. We use another header file in every program, that is hash include conio.h, console input output dot h header file, which consists of the information about the console input output functions like getch, clear screen, etc. We can also use the other header file like hash include math.h, which consists of the information of all the mathematical functions like sine, cos, absolute, square root, etc. There is another header file in C programming language which we always use, that is string.h, hash include string.h, consists of the information about the string manipulation functions like string copy, string length, string concatenation, string upper, string lower, and so on. So these are all inbuilt functions available in C programming language, where we need not have to write any line of code. We just have to pass the parameter to the function and we get the result. It means that the code, actual body of the function, is written by third person, the compiler designer, you can say that. Okay. Now there is another category of function called as user defined function. What do you mean by user defined function? The user can also write or create his own functions if it is not available in the C compiler. For example, there is no sum function available in C programming language. So a user can write his own function for addition of two numbers, that is sum function. Okay. Now the syntax that we use to define any user defined function is this: return type. We have to first write the return type, then the function name, and in the brackets we pass the parameters, or it is also called as argument list. In opening and closing bracket, we write the actual code of the function, and this is called as function body. Now to understand it very well, we'll take an example. Say there is one person, like a head person into the family, who is busy in his family, and he wants to pay the bill, electricity bill of his home. So what he does is, he divides his work to all the family members, different task is given to different family member. So in this case, the family member is called the function name, which is going to perform certain task for the main person in the family. So in our function programming, main program is the calling function, whereas the function defined is called as called function. So here, the person who performs the task of electricity bill from the family is called as function, which perform only a particular task for the main function. Okay. So that function name should be written here. After that, whatever may be the things that he needs to perform that electricity bill task is called as parameter list or argument list required by the function to perform that task successfully. And the number of steps he or she performs to complete that task is called the actual body of the function. That should be written into the curly brackets here, opening and closing bracket. So this is called as function body. Syntax. What do you mean by return type here? Return type is nothing but the acknowledgement given by this function to its caller. It may be integer, it may be character, float, double, or it may be void also in case of the function, user defined functions. See the add function, how it is defined. User defined function add, which performs the addition of two integer numbers. This add function is not available in C programming language. So that's why we define it. So such functions is called as user defined function. Add function which takes two integer parameters, and if you add two integer numbers, the result is also integer. That's why the return type for this function is also mentioned here is integer. We take the help of third variable here and we add two values, z equal to x plus y, and at last we return that value z to it, the caller, and we close the function body here. So this is a small definition of user defined function add. Here add is a user defined function which adds two integer numbers and returns an integer result to its caller. Now we'll see what are the advantages of using functions in C programming language. The first biggest advantage of using functions in C is we have to write the functions only once and we can use it many times. So we write once, use many times the function, correct? Second is it makes program more readable. Suppose you are performing a program for addition of or arithmetic operations on two numbers. If you perform the same program using function say, so there will be four different functions. Every function is responsible for performing certain tasks, like addition, there is another function. For subtraction, there is another function. For multiplication, there is another function. For division, there is another function. And suppose, if the code is written like this, that code will be more readable by any user, end users, right? So always function coding makes the program more readable. Third biggest advantage is debugging task is very easy in functions. You can easily find the errors in function programming. Now consider the previous example of performing arithmetic operation on two numbers. So we have defined suppose four functions, one for addition, one for subtraction, one for multiplication and one for division. And suppose there is a problem into the division function, if there is an error into division function, then user need not have to worry about the other three functions. Three functions are correct and only there is a problem in say division function. So the user has to directly go to the division function code, correct the error and again recompile the program. So finding such type of errors is very easy in function programming. Then the fourth advantage is it saves our time and space. The last important advantage is it saves our time and space. How it saves our time and space? I have given you an example. Say I want to perform addition task into my program 1000 times, and suppose the addition task requires 3 lines of code, and if you do not write a function, I have to write around 3000 lines of code. And if I use function, a function which takes say 3 lines of code, and there is another program which calls this function say 1000 times. So 1000 lines plus 3 lines, so we need only 1003 lines of code to be written into that program. So that way it saves our time and space. The next point is the calling function and call function. There are two things that we always have in function programming, that is called calling function and call function. What do you mean by a calling function in function programming? A function which calls another function is called calling function. So you can say that it is like manager and the worker. So manager is the calling function in that case, whereas worker is the called function. A worker works for the manager. Now what do you mean by called function? A function which gets called by another function is called as called function.